Hi guys, Hobbs again here. Just pulling a little poll here in Gnomeregan. I normally don't do this instance, so simply because it is so spaced out and it's big and takes a lot to round them up, so you got a lot of smaller pulls. If I was pulling by myself, yes, I could rip right through it and loot everything up. Of course, a lot of them would disappear by the time I got to the full loot pile. It's a problem of pulling too big. But then I wouldn't be able to bring my lower levels with me, which I have an all-kill group right here. And they're going to get the experience from this. And a lot of what the Hobbs way of pulling is, it's not just, pulling solo and getting all the loot and getting all the money and yay, I'm rich. Yay! It's also about contributing to your other players and growing together and sharing that experience. So a lot of these players are going to get the benefit of getting the blue bind on pickups, they're going to get some green bind on equips. I'm going to get the loot that they don't need and sell it on the auction house or disenchant it. And for those of you who've seen my videos before, you'll find that this is one of the smaller pulls, but it was a little sample to introduce the Hobbs way of pulling. This video is not a full video on this instance, but a lot of people have been asking to see a bit inside here, so I thought I would show that today. Pretty cool how the animation, how these guys die. So this is a little scene of my Staff of Jordan, the second one that sold for 334 gold after auction fees. It actually wasn't the one that you saw in my last video in the armory. That one Hollander got, and he sold for 238. So here we are in the graveyard, looking at not through Hobbs's eyes but through Gummy's eyes. So you're gonna watch the experience go up at near the bottom, and this was a one pull right to the boss. Gummy's level 27 in this group, and you're gonna notice another familiar face in this. Bobby Pins also in this group, who did the stockades video. So now we're in the library for the second pull, and the key with this one, I can now do library in one full right to the boss, bring both bosses to the first hallway. We're area affecting, we're healing. The key is when the boss area affects, because these guild members are such low levels, you're going to want to make sure that they're far back, because it will one-shot kill them. Oddly enough, you'll see a few of them actually die, and it's a good thing that Gummy didn't die, because it'd be a pretty boring video if he was face down the whole time. So now we loot up. Of course, my loot rules are, if it's something you don't need, pass, and we'll go to myself, the higher level pally. So he's busy healing. We've got some area effect and a second healer in that, and of course another death there. When the boss dies, the key is to remember to run back behind, because two adds will spawn, and if they go on the cloth casters, they'll actually kill them quite fast. Just a little note too, this video is sped up double time, but just so you can see more pulls in the short video. Lots of damage going on there. They run away. Oddly enough, they all come back to, I don't know what the purpose is, run away, and then they figure, oh, well, what am I running for? Let's go back and kill them. It's kind of nice to have that little lull, though, because when they start going by, if you're really low on health, it gives the healers a chance to heal you up. And the other thing, too, with the blue bind on equips, the first few pulls, all the casters and different classes will be wanting it, but after that, it will all go to Hobbs. A little close-up view of some of my gear. The gear itself is great for this type of area effect. Some of it's much lower than my actual pally, but it works great, like the Skull Flame Shield, because it does proc different damage effects and healing effects as well. I'll have all the links to different weapons and that on my, you'll see the link at the bottom, wowhobbs.blogspot.com. You'll see we're already well over half experience now. I do have a couple other videos, guys, where I'm showing all four Scarlet Monasteries. If you like my videos, make sure either A, check out the other ones on my blog, or even subscribe to this channel. So then, of course, we do the looting. There's a lot of loot. You're going to find that the members, the lower level members that go through this, they're going to get a lot of the coin split. They're going to be able to sell the grades, which does add up over time as well. Even in this group, we didn't have any mages, but when you have mages, they're going to be casting Blizzard, and when the group's down to 50%, you're going to come in with the Arcane Blast just to finish them off. You don't want to do Arcane Blast too early, because it can pull aggro off the pally. So this week's weapon is the Mug of Hurt, level 41 blue. You'll find it on Auction House, or you'll find it on a random drop. Got decent stats on it, slows your target, but the best thing is hitting your mob with a beer mug. Or for those of you who aren't old enough, a root beer mug. The sound that it makes when it cracks upside their head is pretty cool, so if you get a chance to use it, and it's just a fun weapon. If you'd like this video, subscribe to Wowhobbs, that way when I make a new one, you'll be the first ones to see it. Consecration areas, or is a spell I use my area effect. Blessing Wisdom I put on the other party members so that they'll have full mana, or they'll regain mana faster. Holy Shield will increase my chance to block, which I use all the time. Holy Wrath, when I'm fighting undead, it's an area effect for just undead. Retribution auras like Thorns, but for a pally, and if I have a druid in my group, I have them cast Thorns. And Greater Blessing of Sanctuary, that will reduce damage on attacks on myself. This is a little view of my blog, guys. Come by, swing by. I've got all my different videos. I have write-ups on underneath. 99% of your questions that you're going to have are going to be answered on that blog. So give it a good read through. There's some clickable links to some of the items and weapons and everything else. Going to end the video with a little view again of the end boss and what he drops for loot. And while we're watching this, just want to thank all my subscribers for helping me grow to this point. And I know a lot of you have been passing my blog information around. And as long as you guys are out there willing to watch these videos, I'm willing to make more of them. So here at the end, you're going to find that it's pretty easy to kill, especially with the level difference. Typically, when you're running this, so at your own level, you want to have the players go around hitting the buttons at the sides here so that the little walking bomb moms don't actually come and kill everybody. So the two-handed axe dropped. Little view of what it looks like here. And just want to give a little clip of myself grinding in the Outlands, and this is how I get, when I'm bored, I get, you know, quick little experience per pull with the Hobbs way of pulling. Till next time, guys.